Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of ASML as the largest supplier of equipment to chip makers missed sales forecasts. ASML shares tumbled 3%. Also in focus, shares of Adidas after it reported better than expected quarterly results and raised its 2024 guidance. Shares of the German sportswear giant last traded higher by 8%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of luxury giant LVMH after its first quarter sales figures matched analyst expectations. Its stock price rose 5% in midday trading.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade on a mixed note as investors assessed Fed Chief Jerome Powell's hawkish statement overnight. Japan's Nikkei 225 slumped 1.3%, falling below the 38,000 level for the first time since February. The Shanghai Composite, on the other hand, jumped 2% after China's securities regulator clarified concerns over delisting rules. Here at home, Philippine shares finally snapped a 9-day losing streak on bargain hunting. The main index now back above 64,000.
For the PSCI, our analysis suggests that the next support levels lies around 64 to 62, and its resistance level is marginally just above 65. And then, should it be broken, the next resistance level sits around 67. Okay. Of course, this assessment is grounded in the index potential to enter the oversold territory, which historically corresponds with a rebound around the 64 mark.
As for the Philippine peso, it weakened against the dollar for a fifth day. The local currency closed 57.18 to the greenback Wednesday. That's a 17-month low. The Philippine Central Bank attributes the peso's depreciation to geopolitical tensions in the Middle East and the possible delay in interest rate cuts from the U.S. Federal Reserve. BSP Chief Eli Remolona adds the peso's weakening is not sharp enough to warrant a change in monetary policy. He also does not see it affecting domestic inflation expectations, but he says the Monetary Board may reconsider cutting interest rates this year.
The central scenario would be fourth quarter ease. If things are worse than we think, then might be postponed to the first quarter of 2025. For now, I think the impact on monetary policy is, I would say, not large. It might be a factor depending on how what happens between now and the next monetary policy meeting. It's not a case of a weak peso, it's a case of a strong dollar.
It's not just the Philippine peso experiencing weakness. Most Asian currencies have slumped against the strong dollar on rising bets of higher for longer rates. Financial authorities from Japan, South Korea, and Malaysia have said they stand ready to intervene to control their currency's volatility.